mentioned before, 12 disciples. It's like we are doing like a batches, and maybe it will take 9 months for a batch to finish it, and then we will take next batch. So now it's Bhavani's turn to share the word, and every month one disciple will share every month. Hallelujah. Let us welcome her.
Let us pray before we start. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, that you prepare every one of us, Lord. We are a family and you are our Father, Lord. Lord, we are here to hear from you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We're just giving ourselves, Lord, to receive your word. In Jesus' name, amen. You know, while worshiping, God said, Holy Spirit, God is speaking to me. I'm giving anesthesia for everyone to prepare Jesus to do the operation. I feel like I got more.
Amen.
Yes, while worshiping song is going, I got that word actually. God was saying, and I was thinking, oh, yeah, it'll be easy, it won't be painful. Today I prepared about, actually, I put my father's secrets, actually, our father's secret. Thursday in the prayer, Friday, so many things when Pastor Sreka was sharing, it's something giving me confirmation. One is city takers. I'm so happy to receive that promise. We are going to be, each one of us is going to become city takers.
Amen.
City takers. I was thinking, oh my God, I'm going to take this Mississauga city.
Amen.
Then I was thinking, who else in Mississauga? Then I thought, oh my God, Elizabeth left a little bit before. Now Sister Sreka, Pastor Vijay and I are moving to Brampton. Only me and Mercy and Susan, I think. And I was thinking Jay, and I was thinking, who else here in Mississauga?
Nagamani.
Oh, Nagamani. I forgot Nagamani, but Nagamani. And, Viola. So I thought, oh my God, just imagine that in Mississauga, we are going to take one by one like that to the kingdom, and how it's going to be. I was really thinking, it's actually, I didn't prepare that, but Friday when I heard that, everything was going on in my mind, how God is going to do, because if I cling what I prepared when I was preparing, even if I also take that message is not only for the church, for everyone, for me and everyone. So I will become more strong, no? My belief become increased to become city takers. Then I had a vision like this, this World Cup and all, when they are going, they put a small flag in the car and all, no? Mm-hmm. That I had a vision. All these highways, they are making large, no? Becoming Mississauga to Brampton. Everywhere the highway, they are doing this construction. And, for us, they are doing. For our church, they are doing. And our vehicles, no? We are going to have that small flag, Zion International Fellowship. So when we are going to take up this city, when we are driving, what I see, when they see the flag, they are moving and allowing us to go front, do the ministry. So I was seeing this vision like that. No, whenever I drive, I think, oh, they are doing for us. Let them do. Let us prepare. So we shouldn't be, when God is giving some visions and all, we have to prepare ourselves. We have to prepare ourselves so that we'll be ready. When Sister Sreka asked me, actually, this month is not my turn. Next month, but I was preparing. When the day she told me itself, I just started preparing. So when she asked me 1 month before, I'm ready actually. And yesterday I was asked someone, one of my daughter's friend, to come to her. I think some of you know that Ammu and Apsi, two girls, they came for the they are Catholics and they have their Holy Communion yesterday. But she asked me, Auntie, can you come and I want you to pray. So I went there. No, I was able to share. I was sharing with Susan. I was able to share a small message. I didn't have to struggle to prepare for today. I prepared. So we all have to prepare. Now we say we have to prepare. Means to know the word. If we don't know, then we cannot. We have to soak into the manual, the lesson, what God has given to us. If we don't know, we have to spend time. We have to read every day. We have to pray about it. We need to prepare ourselves. Then only we can achieve that. Otherwise, it will take a long time. That is one thing. And our father's secrets of how to achieve the promises, the visions, what God has given to us. Mm-hmm. You know, I learned this in my early stage. Not only me, all, if you sit down and if you think about your walk with God, you can remember all these things. Holy Spirit, God will bring you everything into remembrance. I still can remember. I started actually when I was 16 or 17, started to take Sunday school. All the youngsters, I urge you to take starting Sunday school. That is a big start for us, preparing a small lesson and to teach the kids. When you are preparing, you are learning. You are actually learning. All youngsters, the starting point, I can say, even if a girl or boy, Sunday school. There only you will start reading the Bible. You will, I come to know like that only. I started in Genesis 9, 1827. Still, I can remember that I was teaching in a Sunday school. Now, the sons of Noah who went out of the ark were Shem, Ham, and Jephthah. And Ham was the father of Canaan. After that, 1827. Now, the sons of Noah who went out. 19. These three were the sons of Noah, and from these the whole earth was populated. And Noah began to be a farmer, and he planted a vineyard. Then he drank of the wine and was drunk, and became uncovered in his tent. And Ham, the father of Canaan, saw the nakedness of his father and told his two brothers outside. You know, sin. Others sin. If you are going to expose to others, you will be cursed. Always, even if you know, you have to cover the sin. That is the first secret I know. Always I remember that. If I know anything about in my family or in my city or in my workplace, anybody make mistake or any wrong things they are doing, even here the father's sin, the son went and told just the brothers only. He could have, the first step he could have covered, and he could have simply walked away, nothing would have happened. Father got up and he cursed, and he could, the two other brothers who covered only, says blessed, who were covering. So one way of receiving blessed, shut your mouth. Whenever, when the talk or conversation comes, if anything provoke you to talk, be aware of that. Just stop. Don't say anything about if you know anything, especially anything wrong, even in the workplace or wherever anybody make mistake, just pray for them. Cover their sin. Help them to come out from that. You know, they don't know what they are doing actually. Even Noah doesn't know what he was. He just rang and he fell. No, then that is one. Actually, I always remember that. Even yesterday, one of my cousin was called and something she was talking about a thing what happened and what he did, all these things. I said, you know, don't talk. Several times she told me. I told her, don't talk about the past. Cover that sin. You are the one exposing, and that curse is over you. You know, sometimes we could talk about our. Sometimes our brothers, sisters, anybody, no? We have to forget about that. That has gone. We have to cover that. and help them too. That is the one thing I really experienced, that whenever I do like that, God lift me up. God bless me. Even in my family, there are so many things. I always cover my brothers and sisters, my children. Even my children also. If anything, even sometimes when you are counseling also, it's tempted to, my daughters. Don't, even that also, we have to be very careful. This is our children. Yes, everybody, they make mistakes. No, we have to cover, we have to pray for them. Yes, of course, others also, when we are counseling, we have to do a very proper, careful way counseling also. Second thing in my early stage, what I learn is, one is about the Queen Elizabeth. I think I shared this before once in the ladies' meeting. We used to have ladies' meeting, now we don't have, only men's have. We used to have in the basement. I shared this. This is really still touches whenever I see the royal family. We all are royal family. Amen. Our father, King Jesus, royal family. You know, once the Queen Elizabeth, she ruled the whole world. The whole world was ruled by her. And a queen under her, she is in Africa. She visited to Queen Elizabeth, the first queen. No? She visited and she asked, Queen, what is the secret? What is the secret of your success? You are ruling the whole world and there is peace in your country. There is no violence, richness everywhere. When you see, when Queen Elizabeth, when she was ruling the whole country, England was full of richness, no violence. Then she asked, what is the secret in Africa? All violence, poverty, everything. Yeah, that small country, I cannot. How come you are ruling the whole world? What is the secret? She asked. Then she said, she took the queen and she went into her bedroom and she took the Bible and she said, this is the secret. The day and night, what I am reading, what I am meditating, that is helping me to rule the whole world. If she said like that, then how much we can do? We can also rule the world. We can rule the world. And also when you see, no, that family, generation to generation, they are rich. They are happy living. They are not working hard like that. Royal family. Every time when I see, I used to admire, even because of that, I forced to admire all these Charles and Diana, all these things. Only that, because of that revelation what I got, I really used to watch everything they are doing, no? They still, they are, the blessing is there. I don't know what they are doing, all this, I'm not care about that. That is between God and them, but the blessing is there in their family. Psalm 103:17. I think I wrote 7:17. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting on those who fear Him, and His righteousness to children and children. That is what I think. If we walk with God, and we get the mercy, if we are working for God, if we believe in His word, and we meditate day and night, that promise, that blessing will flow to our generation. Amen. Only thing I think, I don't know whether the Queen forget to pray for that for the generation. I don't know. But I wanted that our generation, our church family, we all, imagine all our generation going to follow God. They will carry that blessing generation to generation. Our children, children, children's children, they are going to. So the secret is that one is the manual book, the Bible, the Holy Bible, meditate day and night. So the some of the thing I really, but when I learn first, when I read that about all these things, now when I look back, I'm like an elementary state those days, even about Noah and Queen Elizabeth and most of the stories about Abraham, Joseph, Daniel, Esther, these are Nehemiah. I always text to my son, read Nehemiah, read Daniel. Don't give up reading. Please read. Please read. He'll say, yeah. Yes, Mama. Yes, Mama. I don't know whether he's reading or not. I always send messages to him and for my children also. Nehemiah, it really touches my heart. Joseph's story, really, I learn a lot from him. This all encouraged me to wait patiently for God to fulfill his promises to me, my family, my children, as well as the church also. Similarly, he's going to fulfill his promises. So those early stage is like an elementary school, elementary level only I was. Then I felt that I was in a secondary school level learning. Now I feel like I'm in the university. But I wanted to master. I want to do PhD. That level we have to reach. Then we can, that's a level God will bring us. Definitely if we walk through us. Even in the beginning, when I came to this church, so many teachings was, I couldn't able to take it. I was really doubt actually. One thing I know, God will not take me into the wrong place. That I am very much sure. Even though I don't agree with or something, it was bothering me. One is the umbrella. Come under the umbrella. I couldn't remember now, but I still that only that, not only one few of them, but only thing in my spirit, I know God will not bring into the wrong place to give wrong teaching. Teaching is correct, but I am in the secondary level. Couldn't able to understand. You know, it will take time. Even if you feel like it is not, if you couldn't able to take that, don't worry. You know, it will take time. It will take time. Some of the things we cannot. Sometimes it's really hard to understand also. But the promises are yes and amen. You might think, oh, what is this? Always the same promise. Always when I go for prayer, same promise. Daniel, last time he prayed, don't worry about your children. They have a high callings. Just do your, just work for God. Just do what God wants you to do. That's true. I know. The promises are yes and amen. God give us again and again. Don't get frustrated. Don't get tired. What is this again? Look at Abraham from chapter 12 to 21. Same promise. Same promise. Nation. You are going to be the father of all the nations. Nations only. He didn't say anything else. Only. I will multiply you. I will bless you. Same. Then why we have to worry about different promises? Same promise what is given to us, to the church, that will fulfill. That will fulfill for us. So, and the other thing, also, if our children, our husband, wife, or parents, brothers, sisters, anybody, if you are really struggling, worrying, oh, they are not coming, don't force them. Don't force them to come or don't try to teach them or anything. You know, when they are so small, yes, we have our children. You have to, it's a easy time, you can pull them out, sit down. Every time when my children were small, it was not a problem. We have to have prayer. That for the parents, those who your children are still small till they become high school, you can do that. I was able to do that. I make them to sit down and everybody has to read the Bible, pray, we worship, everything we have done. That time is a good time to push that, everything, the lessons, what they have. One time, they said, Amma, you know, we'll have a plan like this. First, second, third, each children. The eldest, then the second, third. Then first, second, third. Whenever the month comes, 31st, you do. Because they don't want me to do, I'll make a long prayer and long Bible reading. So they will make it short. Anyway, if it is shorter way, I'll make that. Even I still have that calendar. I look at the calendar, I said, God, this is what we were in the starting. I know what you are going to be end. In the middle, whatever happens, it's okay. But end, I know. The fourth dimension, look at what is going to become the end. So, today I'm going to share this. And this, know that fire, I think I'm catching here now. I'm 10 years, I think, with Pastor Sureka. The fire catches, I feel like now the fire catches me. this fire is very contagious. It will really will catch my family and my city. So that fire, the beginning, I myself cover, so that the fire won't catch me. Because I didn't allow some of the teaching was, I'm not blaming myself. I'm not feel why I did like that. No, I'm growing. I don't feel guilty about that. I'm not ashamed about that. I'm telling the truth. Because that time I don't know. God is bringing me from my, I was worshipping, I'm going to a church where my culture, my family, my language speaking, my brother was there, my sister, everybody together, we have a very nice time in that church, no? God brought me into that place here. I'm in that position. I left all my comfort, no? So, that reward will come in the late. But I know I'm not in a wrong place. Even though I lose, I came. I don't know, I think Shaila, so many things she used to say. She used to say, I came with a tissue bag. I don't know how I came. I was in a time that time I really needed. Everybody left. I always think, David, everybody left. But he strengthened himself with Lord. When I came here, I was able to strengthen myself with God. So I strengthened. And even though when the teaching was going on, I was able to receive it slowly. And I came out of my pit. I'm so happy now. I'm so happy I didn't give up and I go back. You know that pastor and the wife? They didn't give up. They always keep connection with me. They always invited me. So I go there also. Then I come back. Yeah. And they call me any Christmas, Easter service, even the prayer meeting in the house, the family members, they invited me. I go. But you know, again coming back. I know the place where I have to be. So I didn't just reject them. I'm happy with them. Then it's still I have a right connection with them. Who knows, maybe they will catch our fire. God brought us from there too. Because I was praying for the city, Mississauga, that time before I'm coming here. I'm praying for the Mississauga Tamil-speaking people, Scarborough Tamil-speaking people. I was praying. But after coming here, 13th January 2nd, we were going to Anita's house. Me, Sister Pastor Sureka, John, and Nora. And on the way we were going, Pastor Sureka said, God is going to use you not only in Mississauga and Toronto, all over the province in Canada, Vancouver and Quebec, and also he's going to open door to US. So I'm preparing for that. Amen. I read this again, January 2nd, 13th, 17 now, 4 years. I always, my verse what God given on this golden book. I always take and read that again and again. I'm preparing. Once God told me in a vision, he gave me that I saw that I'm a chemistry teacher in a Peel District School Board. And I applied for Peel and the Catholic Board. Peel, I got the interview, everything. And Catholic Board still didn't come into my message. Catholic Board, I said no, because Vision Peel Board. I always remember Pastor Vijay's testimony, that job, no? Praying, and nothing seems about the job. Finally, he got according to what Sister Ria said. So I just accept only Peel Board, and I stitch nice clothes for me. I'm going to be a teacher. I stitch a lot of clothes that time, but I couldn't get into the position. For a long time, now it's 14 years. But you know, clothes, even if I get today, I can buy. But I have to prepare the lessons. God gave me a night school actually that time to prepare myself. So last week I got another job, I don't have to prepare. I just went and start teaching. So similar way, only this, the promises were, if we meditate day and night and prepare ourselves, we don't have to struggle. When door opens, you don't have to worry. We can go and take the cities. We can take the cities. We have to prepare. So why I'm encouraged to do all this? One story, Abraham. Abraham's story, when you look at Abraham, when God asked him to, firstly when he was giving the promise, Genesis 12:2, what he gave is, I will make you a great nation, I will bless you and make your name great, and you shall be the blessing. Similar way, we all got some promises. Abraham got this promise when he was 75 years. He was happy. He wanted to move on. Everybody, when we get promises, we are so thrilled, no? He worshipped Lord. He built altar. He worshipped. When you see chapter 12, worshipping. Building altar. Worship. Wherever he goes, he worshipped. And, you know, Sarah was also so happy. Actually, God didn't say where he's going to take him. Before Abraham's father, only God said, not God didn't say, he wanted to go to Canaan. It says before, I think chapter 11, I didn't mark that. He said, he wanted to go to Canaan. He took Abraham and Lot and Abraham's wife, like that some of them from her family. He moved and he went to, can you move to 12, 3? No, that 11 last word. Father settled down. I think Genesis 11. 11, Genesis 11, the last word. So the days of Terah were 205 years and Terah died in Haran. When he came to Haran, he stopped. But he wanted to move Ur. So I read in one book, Ur was the place. Now the archaeologists, they found under the ground, under the earth, a lot of gold, silver, musical instruments, weapons, board games. You know, when I was reading that book, according to the book, I got a picture like Niagara Falls. Ur was a very rich country, very entertainment, games, richness, gold, silver. Even though Abraham's father wanted to go to Canaan. Canaan also a rich place. We all like that. Maybe you say, oh India, oh Sri Lanka, oh my country was good, a big house, weather, fruits, everything we talk about. No, still we came here, some of them with a vision, or I don't know, there are. We also heard about Canada is a good country, we came. He also wanted to go a country where it is more richer than Ur, I think. But he settled in Haran. They are settled him in Haran. But God was saying to Abraham, he was saying, when it comes. Okay, Genesis 15:7. Then he said to him, I am the Lord who brought you out of Ur. God didn't talk that time. When you see in Bible, Genesis 11, nothing about God, nothing about Yahweh. Just there are who went. He wanted to go to Canaan. But God is saying to Abraham, I am the one, I am the Lord who brought you out of Ur of Chaldeans to give you this land to inherit when he was in Canaan. Already planned. Maybe my children also might know. Don't know. They didn't, God didn't talk to them. God only talked to me. I'm the one who took the step to come here actually. So they don't know about that. But God has a big plan over my children, my generation. Amen. So he used me, used you all to bring there. So when Abraham heard this, but when he was in Haran only, God is talking to Abraham. Go to the land where I'm showing. I'm going to make you a great nation. So Abraham was so happy. He was moving. Sarah was so happy because they don't have children. Everybody, whatever we don't have, that is what we wanted, no? No children, they might think, definitely, the great nation, I will have a child. God is going to give a child. God will bless me with a child. Before God speaks also, it is, we can able to judge, no, when blessing means what? Rich for us, what? Richness, healthy children, everything, no? So Sarah was happy, going nicely. Then what happened? Famine. That time when you see, no prayer, no direction, I think. Or he didn't build any altar. He just went to Egypt. Even God give promises, we sometimes walk away from God without his direction. But still, promises are yes and amen. He went to Egypt. He get into trouble. You know, that is a very, I don't know, it's a nightmare, no? Taking Sarah, imagine you are living in a, we are living in a house or we are going somewhere. Some people in that country coming and taking our child, a girl, out from that. We are taking, if Susan and Uncle, somebody come and take Alina, how you will be in that night? No, imagine that day won't rest from our mind for a long time. Abraham, that was a very hard day, no? Just take Sarah, but God intervenes in the correct time. He allowed that disease, the sickness, the disease spread all over the place. No, Pharaoh is not a God man. He quickly realized something is happening. Something is wrong. Sarah, he took it. And he knows something is wrong. Take and go. He just allowed Sarah to take. Abraham, why did you tell me? Why you lied to me that is the sister? Take and go. And the book what I read, it says that Hagar, that time Sarah was giving that girl to serve Sarah. A small, very strong, very healthy and very beautiful girl is Hagar. So she wants Sarah to serve when she was in the Pharaoh's palace. Maybe he was there for 2-3 days, I don't know how many days, that time to serve. So she said, she allowed that girl also to go with Sarah, it seems. Hagar was an Egyptian girl. From here only she came. That author was saying it's not biblically proved, but we can, it is can be, no? Go. Then I thought maybe that girl also didn't get that disease because she is with Sarah. No, that's why I'm saying the fire, if it catch, it will spread those who are with us. Hagar didn't get that disease, I think. That's why he said, go with that girl also, go. Then they left. But only thing, even Abraham was wrong going to Egypt. God's plan is not like that. How God will do all these things? God will allow these things to do? When we get into a wrong time also, God will protect us because he has to fulfill the promise. He has to fulfill the promise. Because he already spoken, that word will not go back to him without doing his job. So he has to done that. He has to bless Abraham. So then after that also, that fear was with Abraham for a long, long time. That because we also know, no, sometimes we do everything. Something when we do that will bother us. We know that. No, we can't say, no, I don't know, I just did it like that. No, we are with God for a long time. When we are doing something wrong, we know that, but we think maybe we'll try this. Maybe we'll try this. Abraham would have tried to go to Egypt. Egypt also a very rich country, no? Maybe that is the place God wanted. When he entered only, he said, oh, I'm in the wrong place. Then he started, oh, say lie to the Pharaoh, tell sister. Like all these things, he started. But God intervenes in that place, put the disease, bring out Sarah, and they were moving. But otherwise, God wouldn't have said in Genesis. This is 15:7. Before that, God is saying, before he say all these things, I am the one brought to you. He said, after these things, the word of the Lord came to Abraham. What are those things mean? After coming from Egypt, he was full of fear, I think. Even though still so many things happening, when Lot was taken by the other kings and he went and battled with them and bring them back, so many things was happening. But why God is telling this? Do not be afraid, Abraham. I am your shield, your exceedingly great reward. He was encouraging because he's carrying that fear. Maybe you might be having something. Even I also sometimes I used to think maybe that is I shouldn't have done like that. I shouldn't have done. That's a mistake, no? We shouldn't think about the past. Sometimes it's easy to preach. It will come into our mind, no? Something we have done. Oh, that is the wrong step. That I shouldn't have done that. You know, even though everything is under God's control. God is there too. That's why every time the promise is the same promise coming again and again. You don't think that, oh, what is this? Every time they are saying like that, nothing is happening. No, it will happen. It has to come to the correct time. Otherwise, God's timing is different. His timing, He will fulfill everything. So one day somebody was saying, no, then I said, you know, in God's calendar, there is nothing negative. Everything is positive. Appointed time, it will happen. Our timetable only different because we are the ones schedule, put the schedule and it's going wrong. God's calendar, everything, Abraham's lesson, I read most of the time from chapter 12 to 21. 12 to 21. You see, same promise God is giving. He fulfilled. He got the child. He got the child when he was 100 years old. You know, God promised 75, then 99, He's saying, you will have a child, not from Hagar. From your own, you will get. After that, He lived for 75 years. So that 25 period, years only, I don't know the time period, those time, maybe that's according to ours. 25 years struggle, 75 years He lived. So for us also it's possible. Don't worry, be healthy. Prepare yourself, bird, and the body will keep healthy. I want to see my great-great-grandchildren serving God. Even my son not yet got any children. My daughter, younger daughter, not yet married. But I want to see them. I want to be healthy to see. Abraham lived very peacefully. I want to live, Abraham died peacefully after seeing 75 years. He see all what happened through Isaac. And so I want to, we all will see that. We all will see how our generation is doing this, the whole nation. We are going to rule the world. But Sister Rebecca said, take it as a word, that is the end time church we are. Who knows, maybe we are going to see that end time church. Our children's children, children's children. We're standing for God to bring this nation, bring this world to the kingdom. So I'm believing that I'm doing. And one more thing also for me, Sarah, you know, she was very abusive. It's in the Hebrew translation it says, when she's the one who gives the idea, you have a child with Hagar. Hagar was very beautiful and serving for 10 years, I think 75 years when Isaac was born. When God, after 10 years it says in the Bible when I read, 75, when Abraham was 75, God spoke to this. When 10 years they were living in a Canaan, that time only in 16 it's talk about the Hagar and all. A girl, a maiden, run away from a housemaid. Imagine how Sarah would be. Sarah was abusive, mistreated Hagar. But the Hebrew translation, Sarah was abusive to Hagar. Abusive. I used to abuse my children. One day my son said, I'm going to leave the house. I was, oh my God, I have to stop now. After that, I never ever shout on him. One word he said, that's then. This lady, Sarah, chased her out of the house. And see, it's a wilderness going away. And one time my daughter said, when my mom opens her mouth, I'll go to the washroom and take bath. So I can't hear what she's saying. I was like that with my children in one point, because coming to Canada from the place, all this I was, my children tried to get into that, even the dressing and all. My son will put the bag and he will come and ask me, Amma, can you put the button? You know, he wanted to put it down. So I had to fix the button, I fix the button, and I give it to him. At the same time, I shout on him. He'll come with a hat on his tennis. I always see tennis. Remember my son always, take the hat out, take it. I'm telling you to take the hat out. Then he will take. Then we all sit in the room. Then I see my son is with the hat in the church. I was thinking, these are the things I did actually. Thank God they didn't run out of the house. Yeah, if they run, they'll have some shelter. But Hagar, wilderness, even though she don't care, let me go out of this woman. Let me leave. So she went. So Sarah was an abusive. But God didn't change his promise because of her abusiveness. To chasing a woman, chasing the one who's serving her, washing her clothes, cooking for her. All these for years and years, a lady is doing, and with a baby, the son is away and going out. Did God change his promise? No. But instead of that, she should have enjoyed the time. Only that period, they all become tired. The promise is not going to fulfill. Because of that, only they reacted like that. But again, God is strengthening Abraham. No, come out. Look at the sky. Your generation is going to be like that. Your generation is going to be like that. So he's encouraging. That's why, you know, if the promise is giving you again and again, you are also same like Abraham and Sarah. You are down. You are thinking, maybe it's not going to happen. That's why the promise again and again. If we know this is going to happen, this will happen. Definitely it will happen. So I think Abraham, even Joseph, everybody's lesson, whatever they went through, but whatever God said, God told that all your brothers are going to bow down. It happened. So whatever promises given, he will fulfill. He will do that. You don't have to worry about it. His secret is, whatever you do, I don't care. I will do. I want you. I choose you. I will fulfill that. That is his. But your choice, Simpson, his life was not, he couldn't able to enjoy his life. But he used Simpson to, Samson, no? I'm correct? Yeah. He killed the Philistines. All of them killed, but he also died in that same time. He couldn't able to experience the goodness of God in the land. So, what I'm saying, be encouraged. That will happen. You have to see that for Paul Yanglicho's book, I was asked to read for my discipleship part, fourth dimension. I am seeing that only. In between, don't see whatever is going on. Let it happen. If you burn, if you catch the fire, that is contagious. It will spread. We don't have to worry. I was thinking the time when I was coming here, the time now I am, I'm so happy. I'm really thankful to God, but I'm not going to doubt anything, whatever you said. I always read this again and again, and I remember you. God said, remember my words. Remember my words regarding your children. You come to me and you remind me. I'm remembering you, Lord. I'm remembering you, you said this. I don't care when it's going to happen, but this will happen. Then the other thing, I used to think like that, prodigal son, Luke 15:31. You know the prodigal son, I don't know how many of you think like that. I used to think like I am the eldest son, like. I am the eldest son. I am always with you, Lord. I am always with you. I am why you are doing this. Why this happened to me? What did I do wrong? I am always with you, Lord. What did I do wrong? Maybe you, some of you might ask. Yeah, I didn't do anything. Yes, I am. Only thing I can say, only thing in my family with my children. That is, I have the right to correct my children. Maybe the ways what I use, maybe I don't know that time. But other than that, what did I do wrong? Then God one day, he told me, you know. And he said to him, son, you are always with me. And all that I have is yours. Whatever he has, is mine. Then why should I simply ask him, what did I do wrong? I don't have to worry about Abraham. That what happened in that midweek, I don't have to do anything. Whatever my father has is for yours. It's me. The power, the glory, everything is for us. He is releasing because he wants to bring this nation through us. If we know that the main idea, we won't we get shaken. The main idea, he wants to bring the nation. He is using us. So that time, he will bless us also. He will meet our needs. He will do whatever. And he has said in Colossians 3:12, therefore, as the elect of God, we are the elect. Elect of God, holy and beloved, put on tender mercies, kindness, humility, meekness, long suffering. You know, the suffering will be enjoyable. You know what is the end product? For me now, suffering is so, I really enjoy that. You know, you can enjoy even when you are going through hard time, because you know what is going to come out of that.
Amen.
So the suffering is really, if you know the truth, even tears will come. I cry a lot. Tears will come when we are going through suffering. It's hard. It's painful. Tears will definitely come. Most of the time when I do worship here, I cry. Because tears will come. We are human beings. So it will come. But why the cry is the end? What is the end product? That is only I'm looking for. If you look for the end product, suffering is nothing actually.
Amen.
I think that's it. For me, I'm so happy to... Actually, oh, one thing I wanted to... And this is 15:6. Genesis 15:6. And he believed in the Lord, and he accounted it to him the righteousness. Accounted in it to him. In one translation, the credit. I always think about the credit card. Credit card, no? When I was preparing credit card, bank will give, no? They will increase our amount according to how we are using the money and all, no? They increase 10,000, 15,000, 30,000, they go over 50,000 also. You know, how much you believe, God is depositing in our spiritual bank, credited. The blessing, he's
Amen.
Depositing. Abraham says like that, I got this, Abraham's spiritual bank account. Sizable deposit was made in Abraham's spiritual bank account. Because he believed. Even though he do some of the thing wrong, he believed. He believed. But he believed and he did something like going to Egypt. Only two. That with the Hagar. No? We also, because Abraham, at least for us, we have this. For Abraham, nothing that time. For him, God knows everything. For us, only lesson, Lisa. No? So he believed that because of that. That's why I thought, and that whatever he putting in credit, the blessing, we didn't borrow from God. He has given to us. It's not borrowed. It's given to us. It is for us forever. God is given that blessing forever. Yesterday, place I went, I didn't prepare anything actually. Monday to Friday I'm working. Saturday morning I'm working. Then I came back. Then my son called from the airport, Amma. Sanya texted, Auntie, we are landing, can you pick us? Then I already prepared, I am not worried about this. I already prepared, so I went to the airport, came back, then I went to my daughter's friend's house. Now then I was asking God, what can I tell, what is the message? She asked me to pray only, so I wanted to give a small message. Then I asked, I was thinking, and then before going to the house, God reminds me that, you know, in the Revelation, I'm knocking in the door, whosoever open, I'll come and dine with you. So I just shared with her. Sindhu, when you ask Auntie, I'm inviting you for Amu's Holy Communion party. But I want you to pray. This is what she said. No? Then I told her, you know, when you invite her, you heard the knock. God is knocking, everybody's. You know, God is knocking the whole nation's door. Jesus is knocking. So many of them, they are hearing, but they are not inviting him. She invited me. She invited Jesus. She asking me, She invited. Hallelujah. She opened the door. You opened the door and you invited.
Amen.
That's why I came here. So everybody we came with a gift. But when God came, He's a king, He also came with a gift. The gift what we brought only will last for 1 or 2 years, maybe a month, or maybe only today. After the gift is gone. The gift, the joy, or wealth, or peace, the God, when God comes, do you think He comes just without a gift? The gift He bring to us, bring to your house, is forever for you. Forever. You know, that's a small message, 1 minute. That's why when Pastor was saying, don't pray for long. God is wanting to receive His blessing, release His power. Quick. So I just told that and I prayed, that's it. And her husband, he came when I was sitting in the sofa, he came. Amma, he put his hands, Amma, it touches me. He said, it touches me. I told God, oh my God, I'm ready to go anywhere. I want to prepare, I'm ready to go anywhere.
Hallelujah.
And her mom in the kitchen when I was taking the food, the friend's mom said, sister, I really feel like crying when you are praying. So it's encouraged me. God has encouraged us so many times when we are doing. When you do, God will encourage you. This is not my thing. We are just a vessel. We are just do. I'm telling you, when you do God's work, God will take care of what you want.
Amen.
Don't worry about your husband or wife or children or father or mother or brother or sister. Everybody will take. It's like a fire, forest fire. When it started, how the animals ran, enemy will run like that.
Amen.
All the enemy will go.
Amen.
Okay, let us pray.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for the word that you have given to us, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Help us, Lord, to encourage us, Lord. Thank you for your encouragement through Abraham, Lord. That story, that real story that Abraham's. Lord, you fulfilled the promise. What you said, you have given the child. Whatever you've spoken over our church, Lord. Lord, we believe that we are going to become the city takers.
Amen.
We are going to rule this nation. We are going to stand for you, Lord. We know that. We know that, Lord. Help us to prepare ourselves, Lord. Give that time to spend time to read and meditate and to prepare and to... When the time comes, when you are sending, Lord, we want to be ready. Lord, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for Pastor Vijay and Pastor Sureka, Lord, that all those things that you are putting in their heart, in their mind, Lord, I know that. I know that, you are preparing us for the end time church, Lord. Lord, everything, whatever you are doing, we are thankful, Lord. We are not worthy, but because of you, you lifted us, Lord, into that higher position. We know that, Lord, what you are going to do for us, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the promises, Lord. We are going to cling on that, Lord. We are not going to take any step without your permission, Lord. Whenever you are loving, we are going to take the step, Lord. Help us, Holy Spirit. Help us to hear that noise, Lord. When you are speaking, Lord, we want to do it quickly, Lord. We want to do that, Lord. We are ready, Lord. We are ready. Equip us, Lord, more and more. More and more, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
It's encouraging.
Amen.
How many of you are blessed?
Amen.
Well blessed. Praise the Lord. I really feel that God wants to touch all of you, and whoever has a need of healing, please come forward with an expectation. Any pain, anywhere pain, any you need healing anywhere, please come forward. Or any other need also, any problem, anything is bothering you. Any problem in the family, anything, that also please come. Anything you're feeling, mind tortured, please come. We pray for you. Hallelujah. 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 Sister Bhavani, come. You also come and pray. Please come and minister to people. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Rabashikandarabalakaramandarabala Shikarabalaka. Rikamandarabala Shikarabandarabalasya. And Daniel and David ministering to people. The way how God used them to heal. To heal the sick. Every person in this church, God is going to use them. Even you are a young person, doesn't matter. One thing, prepare yourself in prayer all the time. Come before you come to church. Morning. Can I ask you that question again? How many of you got up in the morning and pray? Before you come to church, you pray. Praise God. Praise God. Come, Shaila. You also come forward to pray for people. Come. Hallelujah. You need to prepare yourself before you come to church. Pray at home. Every day, pray in the mornings, every day. Before you leave the house, pray and leave the house. Even when you're coming to church, pray and come. Hallelujah. Rabba Shikara Mandara Bala Sikara Baba 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 Rika Mandara Bala Shikara Mandara Bala Siya. As I said last time, you know, it's not a long prayer. God is not like looking for you to pray a long prayer so that He's impressed with your prayer and come and heal people. No, beloved, God loves people. He wants to heal them because He paid price for them. He doesn't want anybody to suffer. So just be quick. Be quick when you are praying for a person. Just use the name of Jesus because there's a power in the name. I don't know how many of you heard me talking about that power in the name of Jesus. Thursday I was talking. You know, the people who are not coming for Thursday intercessory prayers, please, when he's uploading that in Sion group, please go to that and listen to that whatever I was giving on intercessory prayers, because everything is very important these days. I'm telling you, every word what God is downloading into my heart, God is preparing us for a bigger thing. Take every teaching, please. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Be quick, use the name of Jesus, because in the name of Jesus there's healing, there's deliverance, there's restoration. In and speak the name of Jesus over every person here. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And also Shihan and Donald, can I ask you to come, please? Shihan and Donald, you know, one of our dear sister in our church felt Holy Spirit God's telling her, showing her you both to her one sister in our church. God showed you both to one sister. God wants to use you both for His kingdom. There's a mighty calling upon your life.
Hallelujah.
Once I came to your home and I prophesied, you remember? Prophesied over Donna. God has a plan.
Hallelujah. Amen.
It's been coming again and again. Even once I remember Brother Dennis also prophesied over you. And Sister Alithya also she doesn't know you at all. But when she was praying, she saw your vision. That God is you going to use you both for the extension of His kingdom.
Hallelujah.
There's something about you.
Amen.
God is going to touch you today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh Rabba Shikara. Alithya, you also come forward, please. Sharabala Balakara Mandara Balakara Baba 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 Bakara Mandara Balakara Balakara Mandara Baba Baba Baba. Come forward to pray to Minister Shaila. Today Shaila, Alithya and Bhavani, they're going to minister to people. Hallelujah. They pray. Start praying, please. Start praying. Use the name of Jesus. Release power in the name. Hallelujah. There is healing in the name. There is deliverance in the name. There is restoration in the name. Oh Rabasandara. Be quick. Don't take too much time with each person. Just be quick in prayer.
So anybody celebrating their birthdays or anniversaries? I love you.
You have to go and play the music. No? You have to go and play the music.
Let's lift them up in loving Heavenly Father God. Lord, we thank you for Gina and David. Lord, we thank you, Father God, that they have chosen them, Lord. They have chosen presence, Father, to carry
you. Amen.
Lord, I ask, Father God, thank you, Father God, for them. Thank you, Father God, for, Lord, the talents that you have given them, Lord. Lord, for the gifts that you have given them. Lord, where you have placed them, Lord. Lord, thank you, God, that you are using them. Lord, I ask that they will continue to use them, Lord. Lord, I ask that you make them to be a blessing, Father God. Blessing, Lord, to the church family, Father, to their families, Lord, to their workplaces, Father, and Lord, in their cities, Father God, Jesus. Lord, I ask, Father God, that, Lord, that you will fill their lives, Father God, with joy and happiness, Father. Lord, ask that, Father God, you are a promise-keeping God, that, Lord, that out of your bounty, Father God, I ask, Lord, that you will shower them with blessings, Father. Lord, I thank and praise you for them. Lord, I also, God, lift up, Father God, that, Lord, thank you for this time, Lord, that spend it in presence, Father. Lord, thank you for your word, Father. Thank you for reminding us again, Lord, that you are a faithful God.
Amen.
That you are a promise, that you are a promise-keeping God, that you never fail us, Father. Lord, thank you, Father God, just speaking through the life of Abraham, Father God, how you kept your promises, Father God. Lord, we also, Father God, thank you for your word, Father, that you have placed us in our cities, Father, to be city takers, Lord. Lord, we ask, Father, that when we rise up to this calling, Father, Lord, I thank and praise you, God, for each one who's here. I ask, Father God, that you bless them, Lord. Bless this week ahead, Father. And now, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Amen. And can now anybody else come and sing Happy Birthday? Thank